Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. My name is Nikita and today we're going to start a new sort of like a series that I want to do on my YouTube channel, and it is going back to my old palettes that I have and just re-loving them and falling in love with them again, because at the moment times are tough and not everyone can afford to spend money on new palettes and things like that. So I completely understand that, somewhat in the same boat myself. So it would be really nice to appreciate the things that I've already got and to play around with them, and hopefully give you guys some inspiration to play around with yours as well. I'm going to start with the Anastasia Beverly Hills Riviera palette. I've got plenty to get through. There's at least maybe 10, maybe more palettes that I should really go back to and play around with, and rather than just going straight for my favourites every single time, it's nice to go back to those ones and get some use out of them. Plus, I'm never going to actually get use out of them unless I use them. So why not have a bit of a play with old ones and see what we can come up with. So I've done this look today. I filmed it for you and I filmed one of the eyes, and yeah, let me know what you think. Hopefully you guys like it. We're also going to be playing with some magnetic eyelashes, which have been really fun, and I think I may have found my new love, because they are for once not making my eyes water. My eyes have not been streaming and we've actually got on really well with them. So yeah, we're gonna be playing with those today and just generally having a bit of a chit chat, seeing what you guys are up to in isolation and letting you know what I've been up to. So if you want to drop me a comment and let me know what you've been doing, then we can have a chat about it. That would be really, really nice. So please don't forget to like my videos, drop me a comment and subscribe to my channel, and don't forget to follow me on Instagram so that we can all stay in touch and get through this together, because we all need each other right now and I definitely need you guys. It keeps me going anyway. So yeah, if you want to see how I came to this look with this palette, then carry on watching. Okay guys, so we're ready to start this eye. I'm going to start off as usual with my P. Louise base. Just going to pop some up here. Before I spread that, I need to put my tape on. There we go, so we've got the tape on. The reason that I've popped this on is because I'm going to be using a magnetic lash today, and I'm hopeless at doing black wings or any kind of wing liner. So yeah, I cheat by using tape and I'm not ashamed of it. So yeah, let's crack on. So I'm popping this P. Louise base pretty much everywhere. Not really sure if I'm feeling this look today. It's a bit, I was gonna say it's not very colourful, but it is pretty colourful. It's just not multicoloured. I would have liked maybe a purple shimmer to use. Maybe I should have used some of the lighter eyeshadows in the front of the cut crease, but never mind. You live and you learn, and my tape is definitely not even. I should adjust that now. Only a slight adjustment, but hopefully it'll make a bit of a difference. If they're not even, doesn't really matter. Not going anywhere. It's all coming straight off afterwards, but it's all part of the fun, isn't it? Okay, so Riviera palette. And we're gonna start off with the shade Cannes, this one just here. I'm gonna take that brush out because I can see that falling and making a horrible noise. So, Cannes is gonna go up here because it's gonna create the shape. And on this side, you really can't see the purple. So I'm gonna try and make it so you can see the purple on this side. And yeah, they're not gonna match. What's new? Obviously didn't take it high enough on that side. And I normally do that side on camera. So I wonder if that's made a difference because I did that eye first. What have you guys been up to while you're in isolation? I have been watching lots of Netflix, playing lots of PlayStation, cooking lots of food, and putting lots of makeup on. That about summarises my time in isolation, to be honest. What else have we been doing? Oh, so we did have a... My husband and I decided that... Oh, sorry, I'm just going in with the shade Bahamas, this bright pink. My husband and I both needed to give ourselves a bit of a pedicure. Well, actually, I say that. My husband didn't need to. He said, babe, bottom of my feet are really rough. What do I do about it? And I said, you need a pedicure. So we decided to give ourselves a bit of a spa day. So I put like candles and incense and spa music on from Spotify on my phone in the bathroom. And we had a spa day. And it was actually really, really fun. We gave each other facials using a few of my skincare products. And what else did we do? We gave each other foot massages, did face masks. My husband will probably hate that I'm telling you this, but I don't care. We had a great time. Actually, I did take a photo of us in the face mask, so I'll pop that up here for you guys to see it. It was good fun. At the start, I was like, we need to take this all seriously. We need to have a nice, proper relaxation day and get nice and chilled. And this was yesterday, so Good Friday. So I said, we'll start the weekend, get our skin all nice and clean and ready for the weekend so we can relax and just get in the right mind frame, you know? And I'm just going to go in with the shade Monte Carlo, this sort of babyish pink. So we said we'd like get all nice and chilled and get ready for the weekend and stuff like that. And then we actually ended up having so much fun. I was crying with laughter while he was trying to give me a facial, because I did his facial like all nice and just gonna use my Morphe M507 to blend that out. So yeah, I gave him a really nice, I think quite professional facial, right? Where I didn't like slap a load of water on his face. I used a muslin cloth to like wipe off the face mask and made sure that I wasn't drenching him in water. And yeah, it was just a nice facial in general, really. Like I pretended to be a person that gives you facials. What are they called? I don't know what their name is. Dermatologist? No. Spa technician? I don't know, anyway. So I did my best attempt at giving him a nice professional facial and was being really gentle and delicate, although he'll tell you otherwise. So I put a towel down on the bed purposely so that if like the face mask that we had on were a bit runny or anything like that, so it would just run off onto the towel or like not onto the bed or the pillows that were underneath us, so that if there were any dribbles it was caught. And of course, just as well I did, because my neck, my hair, everything was soaking wet from his most unprofessional approach to my facial. To be honest, I didn't actually mind because it was so funny. I was crying with laughter by the end of it, and he took that opportunity because I was crying with laughter. And you know when you cry so much you can't, or you laugh so much you can't breathe? He took that opportunity to put a load of water in my mouth and to start splashing me with the bowl of water that he had and the cloth. And it was just a bit of a, it was a nightmare to clean up, but it was so worth it and so much fun. I'd been really nice to him. He's got really ticklish feet. Like, he hates me touching his feet at any time. And when I gave him his pedicure and his foot massage, I didn't try to tickle his feet once. And I'm normally like whenever we're playing around, I'll try and tickle his feet. It'll be the first thing I go for. But it was really nice. Took that all into consideration. Wanted him to have a really nice, relaxing spa time. But I just caught vitamin C water in my mouth. Oh, it was so much fun though. It was like, being in isolation, things can get a bit miserable and a bit monotonous and boring, really. Like, it's very rare that you find anything to have a proper belly laugh at. But this, it was just so much fun. So much fun. So if you guys are bored and you've got someone at home that you can play with like that, I highly recommend it because I had a great time. And even if we hadn't have ended up being stupid and messing around and throwing water at each other, we would have ended up really nice and relaxed, because when we did have our face masks on and we had to lay there and not do anything, I think I had mine on for like 20 minutes. I must have fallen asleep for a good 10 minutes. It was lovely. It was actually really, really nice. Right, so I'm going to cut my crease with my P. Louise base. I'm going to try doing this on camera. We'll see how we get on. So popping some on the back of my hand, and I'm using a dough colour flat brush. I don't know what this is, but I really like using this to cut my crease. Just trying, making sure I haven't forgotten any of the steps I did on the other eye. I'm going to try not to go too much into that purple. They don't match. They don't match in the slightest. No. Never mind. I think this is a lesson to me not to do your right eye on camera. Do your right eye first, because your right eye always comes out better. And then do your left eye on camera. But you know what? Most of the eye looks that I do don't match anyway, so not much new around here. So I have got some magnetic eyelashes to play with today. Quite excited about that, because I'm hopeless at applying eyelashes. So now I'm going to use my Lamora small shader brush, and I'm going in first with the shade Seaside, which is this silver shimmer. You can't really see that that's silver. It's not coming up on camera as silver either, but it is right here, and it's just like the creamiest silver I've ever used. So the magnetic lashes that I've got are from Amazon. If I can find the link to the ones that I've got, I'll put them down in the description box below. But yeah, they're just something different, because I had a mare with lashes the other day. My eye actually started watering. I need to put some more of that pink in the inner corner. There you go, that will do. Yeah, so my eye started watering and streaming. The lashes were on, they were stuck, and for some reason, I don't know whether some glue got in my eye or something happened, and I could not, for the love of me, stop my eyes from watering. So going in with Seychelles, that blue glitter next, and the like, all of my under eye came off, all of the eyeshadow that was underneath my under eye, all of the makeup, and then my eyelash just started peeling off. Even though the glue was dry and everything was set and done, and I'd finished my makeup look, eyelash just came off willy-nilly, as it felt like it. so I went straight on Amazon and ordered some magnetic ones and thought I need to try them. But I did see an eyelash hack the other day on our makeup group and from Make Me Up Missa. Sorry, I mention her every single video I do, I pretty much, but she is my favourite. If you don't like her, I suggest you go somewhere else because I'm not going to stop talking about her. And if you haven't looked her up already, I don't know what you're doing. You need to go and find her. Mediterranean, this shimmer next. I'm just wiping my brush off on my towel in between. Yeah, so that eyelash hack was to... You actually place the eyelash glue straight on your eyelid rather than on the eyelash and then putting the eyelash on. So that way the glue dries quicker because your skin is obviously warmer than an eyelash. Theoretically, and I've seen some of the girls do it, you just plop your eyelash on and it pretty much sticks straight away, so it's in the position you want it in. Just give it a little wiggle in the places that aren't right and job's a good one, theoretically. Whether that would work for me or not, I don't know. But I'm really excited about these magnetic eyelashes, so we're going to try these today. And if they don't work, then we go back to trying the eyelash hack. Okay, so that's all the shimmers done. I'm just going to pop a bit more of this Seychelles shade. Oh, saying Seychelles, and actually using this palette in general is really making me want to go on holiday. And it's my birthday next month on the 1st of May. And hubby and I, we're going to go on our baby moon in May. So I'm just going back in with cans to blend that blue and purple. We were going to go to Morocco for our baby moon and for my birthday. So we were going to do sort of two trips in one. And obviously because of the current situation, those plans have been put on hold. It was going to be like a real birthday treat and we were going to go at least first class or business class or something like that. But that horrible thing that we shall not mention, because this is a happy place, not a sad place, that had to come along and ruin it. And with the baby coming in August, I don't know when our next holiday will be. So it is what it is. I'm very fortunate that I can even go on holiday, so like I'm not that mad about it. There's so much worse that could be happening right now and is happening right now, but yeah, this palette makes me want to go on holiday. So I'm just going to use my Morphe M507 with the shade Monte Carlo again, just here. And then I'm going to finish it all off with the shade Estate between all the shadows that are there and my eyebrow. Just so that whole space has got some eyeshadow on it, basically. I feel like that Bahamas, the bright pink, really loses its intensity quite quickly. As soon as you put anything near it, it just hides away. It's definitely not as pink as the other side. And they don't match, like we keep on saying. Stop drawing attention to it, Nikita. Right, that's the eyeshadow done. So I'm going to pop a black liner on. This isn't the magnetic one. This is just my wing liner stamp from Amazon a long time ago. It's got a stamp on one end and a pen on the other end. I've given up with the stamp because I still can't get that right. So I just use the pens. But if you do struggle with wings, those stamps are really good. I just don't really like them that much. I don't like the shape of the wing that they give. I'll show you actually. So the wing shape is like that. And like that's not, what eye is this? This is a right wing. So this would be this eye. And like it bleeds out a little bit, and I'd just rather use tape. If I'd already had my whole face done and I'd done a look and I thought, oh, do you know what, this needs a wing, I would use the stamp. And then I'd keep going in with eyeliner until I probably cocked up the whole look. But I don't really need to when I can use tape. And I know it's such a cheap method, but it's just so much easier. And there's a couple of girls on our makeup group that can just throw a black wing liner on as easy as pie. And it gets me so jealous, I'm not even gonna lie. So I do wanna give a big shout out to my Princess Ruby, who is my cousin. And I spoke to my family this morning and she's been watching all of my videos. So Ruby, if you're watching, love you lots. And I really, really miss you all. I miss everyone, I miss all my family. But hopefully we haven't got that much longer. Right, so let me pull off this tape so you guys can see the nice satisfying moment that we all love. There we go. Are they even? Nope. Do we care? Nope. So I'm gonna go and pop the rest of my base on and I'll do one under eye and then I'll come back and do the other eye with you. So I'll be right back. Okay guys, so we are pretty much done. We've just got to do the under eye and lashes on this side. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna start off with the shade Cannes, the deep purple. Well, it's not that deep actually. And I'm going to use that on my Morphe Jeffree Star JS13 brush. We're just doing this on the outer half. I did by accident put some Barry M eyeliner in my eye already, but it's fine because we need to go back in with it. So we are going to use next the shade Bahamas, the bright pink, on my Jessup 237. That's just gonna go under this purple. It's gonna get a lot bigger than this, as you can see, so don't panic just yet. And I'm gonna use my Morphe M508 and the shade Cannes again, because I want that quite tight to my waterline. This brush can be a little bit harsh under your eye. And back in with my Jessup 237 with Bahamas. And it's getting a little bit edgy there. By edgy, I mean like harsh edges, harsh lines. So I'm using my Morphe M152. That sort of the thing. Yeah, and now we're going to use my Lamora small shader with Palermo, this one, the pink shimmer on the inside. And then some more pink under the eye, that Bahamas shade. And I'm gonna go back in with my Morphe Jeffree Star JS13 with the purple. Right, so magnetic lash time. I have one lash on already, as you can see, and I don't want to speak too soon, but I kind of love them. So I've got these Ivy Lush magnetic eyelash, and you get three different eyelashes. I'll show you. So you get three different lashes. They sort of vary in dramaticness. that's them. And I've just gone for the top one for now. And they are stuck to the packaging with this little, you can see the one that I've used already, it's got this little magnetic strip. And the reason I chose these is because I always find I have to trim my eyelashes. And these ones, hopefully you're going to be able to see, have got six magnets on them. Don't know if you can see that. But it means that you can trim the edge if you need to. And I always have to. So just going to measure it up quickly before. And yeah, I'm going to trim the first magnet off the inside. So I've just trimmed off that tiny little bit of the front lash. So I'm going to keep that just in case, because we don't like waste around here. And you never know, I could use them as a underlash or something. So it comes with this eyelash applicator, and it also comes with magnetic eyeliner. So that's what we're going to use. And you have to let this dry before you put the lashes on, otherwise it's pretty pointless. So I'm just going to go over the black wing that I've got already. And it has gone in my eyelashes, but I'm not too worried about that. And you get this nice thin applicator, which is always good. But I would definitely not be able to draw a wing without this. With this, sorry. So I'm going to let that dry and just pop some mascara on, and then I'll come back and we'll do the lash. Okay, so mascara is on and dry, and these lashes are sticking to everything, sticking to my tweezers, my mirror. So I'm going to use my tweezers, because I do find that those eyelash applicators can be a bit clunky. And I'm going to start with my inner corner, just pop it on like that, and I'm going to go along pressing the other ones into place. And I don't like that too far over. And it's so easy, you can just peel it off and plop it back on again. So I'm going to pop it there. And there. Give it a wiggle. Just rearranging them a little bit. And that's it. How easy was that? Some of you may find applying eyelashes normally that easy, but I certainly don't. It normally takes me a good 15-20 minutes to apply a lash, so for me that was a breeze. And I love it. I think it looks great. I've read somewhere that they can be harmful to your eyes. I have no idea. I'm not going to pretend that I know about that, because I don't. But I literally have makeup on while I film, and then I take it straight off after. So it's not going to be on there for a long amount of time. So yeah, what do you think? They're really comfortable. They don't feel heavy at all. They actually feel lighter than some of the lashes that I've got, like normal eyelashes that you glue on. So yeah, if you're interested in magnetic eyelashes, I would go for it, absolutely. So I'm just going to pop some setting spray on. I'm going to use the Revolution Hyaluronic Fix, because this one needs to be finished. I should have done this before, but I didn't, I forgot. So, and we're done. That is the final look with my Riviera palette. I'm quite happy with it. Could have done with using some more of the other colours in there, but I'll go back to it and use it again another time. Let me know what you guys think. I know it's not a new palette, it's one that's really old, year or two now, I'm not sure how old it is, but but I had fun playing with it, and as always, I love filming with you guys, and I'm going to try and go back and revisit as many as I can while we're in quarantine. Just gives me something else to do that A, doesn't cost any money, and B, is actually pretty good, because at this time we need to remember that we've got to appreciate what we've got. So whether that be your friends, your family, social media, being able to communicate with them, anything. It's just nice to be able to go back to the ones that I've got and do something a little bit different, and to be able to do it with you guys. So let me know what you think. I am gonna go and have my dinner and get ready for the sausages Zoom party later. I've got a couple of hours, so I'm gonna keep these eyelashes on and see how they wear. I know I just said that I take them off straight away, but I have a reason to be done up today, so they're gonna stay on, just for a comfort test more than anything. But yeah, I hope all of you guys are really keeping well and keeping your spirits up, and I hope that I'm just, even if it's just for a little bit, I'm keeping you entertained somehow. Don't forget to get in touch with me, like my videos, drop me a comment, subscribe to my channel, and follow me on Instagram, all that sort of good stuff. And yeah, I have nothing to do during the day when I'm not filming, so if you have nothing to do, then just drop me a message and I'd love to stay in touch with you guys. But thank you so much for watching, and I will see you on the next one. Bye guys!